Hi everyone, my name is Anushka Jain and I work as the Associate Counsel for Transparency and Right to Information at Internet Freedom Foundation. As part of our ongoing Watch the Watchman series, in which we take a closer look at the various surveillance technology projects in India, today I'm going to talk to you about the Crime and Criminal Tracking Network System. Like NatGrid and CMS, CCTNS was also developed in the aftermath of the 26/11 Mumbai terror attacks. The then Home Minister P. Chidambaram felt that the internal security structure of the country needed to be strengthened, and thus CCTNS was one of the many projects that he introduced. The pilot testing for the core application software of CCTNS started on 1st October 2011, and the testing continued till January 2013. The pilot launch of CCTNS was done by the Ministry of Home Affairs on January 4, 2013 at New Delhi. The project was originally scheduled to be implemented by March 2015. However, there were multiple consistent delays in the implementation. Currently, the overall implementation of the project is at 77.8%. The total estimated cost of this project is 2,000 crores, and the actual expenditure as on March 6, 2018 is 1,451 crores. Before we talk about the privacy concerns surrounding CCTNS, we should talk about what the CCTNS actually does. The CCTNS was envisaged as a system which would help police stations across the country to talk to each other. The aim of the project is to digitize all information related to FIRs registered, cases investigated, and charge sheets filed in all police stations in order to develop a national database of crime and criminals. The project is being implemented as a mission mode project under the National E-Governance Plan of the Government of India. The National Crime Records Bureau is a nodal project implementation agency for review, monitoring, and coordination of the project under the overall guidance of the Ministry of Home Affairs. In response to a parliamentary question, the Minister of State in the Ministry of Home Affairs stated the aim of the project as follows: to fully computerize the process of crime registration, investigation, prosecution, etc. in all police stations in the country, to create a central database to provide national level search facility as well as crime analytics for use by police and central agencies, to electronically share data and information among police stations and police higher offices, the computerization of all prisons and provisions of necessary hardware, software, etc., to provide citizen services through a citizen portal, and the sharing of crime and criminal related data with police, prosecution, courts, prison, and forensics, leading to integrated criminal justice system. Now we come to the privacy concerns surrounding the CCTNS. The CCTNS itself is not that problematic. However, the problem arises when we talk about integrating the CCTNS with other surveillance technology projects such as the NatGrid and the AFRS. As we all know, there is no data protection law currently in place in India, as well as there is a serious lack in the surveillance architecture of the country. What this means is that we don't have any authority which would ensure that the data of the Indian citizens is protected and that the government cannot engage in mass surveillance. In the absence of both of these important legislations and in the absence of any rules that the government has to follow, the integration of CCTNS with other surveillance technology projects such as the NatGrid and the AFRS would lead to a lot of problems. For example, in a situation where a person has been wrongfully arrested, the integration of their data into CCTNS would lead to a further violation of their rights. This is because their data is now available to the NatGrid and to the AFRS. This allows the government to track their every movement and ultimately violate their fundamental rights. And here, it is important to keep in mind that this person has been wrongfully arrested. That means that he should not have been arrested in the first place. This look into CCTNS is the third in IFF's new series called Watch the Watchman, wherein we look at surveillance technology projects. Thank you.